नमस्कार, दिस इज जानवी फ्रॉम NSDL. आई वेलकम यू इन NPS की पाठशाला. एज यू ऑल नो, नेशनल पेंशन सिस्टम दैट इज NPS वॉज इंट्रोड्यूस फॉर ऑल सिटीजन्स ऑफ इंडिया फ्रॉम मे 2009 एंड टू एंश्योर दैट इट रीचेज टू मासेस, रेगुलेटर PFRDA हैज अपॉइंटेड वेरियस बैंकिंग एंड नॉन बैंकिंग इंस्टीट्यूशंस विच आर कॉल्ड पॉइंट ऑफ प्रेजेंस दैट इज POP. द ब्रांचेस ऑफ दीज POPs आर द फर्स्ट पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग NPS रिलेटेड सर्विसेज which are called Point of Presence Service Providers, that is POP SPs. Most of the POPs are dealing with various financial products like mutual funds, stock broking, etc., and experience in convincing the customers. Since these POPs now have responsibility of distribution of NPS, like in other products, POPs have to convince subscribers to invest in NPS also. Therefore, for POPs and especially for POP branches, as they are first point of interaction for subscriber, it is important that they have all information related to NPS so that they can provide efficient services to the subscribers throughout their NPS journey. So in this video, we'll talk about the role of POP and POP branches in NPS operations. And to talk about this, I have with me my senior colleague, Mr. Mandar. Sir, NPS ki paathshala mein aapka swagat hai.
Thank you, Janvi.
Sir, please tell us in detail about roles and responsibilities of POP and POP branches in NPS operations.
Janvi, as on date, there are more than 75 POPs having 80,000 branches available for NPS related services. As you rightly said, majority of the POPs are banks and financial institutions, which deal in various investment products other than banking, like mutual funds, insurance, stock broking, etc. Along with these financial products, these POPs have a responsibility of distribution of NPS also. This is another business vertical for POPs, and they consider NPS also as a long-term revenue generation source for them. And if we talk from subscriber point of view, for them, investment in NPS is a long-term decision, and for this, they need to get thoroughly convinced to invest in NPS. Therefore, the first and foremost responsibility of POP and its branches is to have complete knowledge of features and benefits of NPS so that they can convince subscribers for investing in NPS. Like, what are the investment options under NPS? What are the tax benefits from NPS investment? Returns generated from NPS? How much pension a subscriber will get after he retires, etc.?
Sir, these POPs have large nationwide network and they are located even in far-flung areas. And information related to NPS should be uniformly available to each and every branch. So how and from where POP branch can get this information?
Janvi, ye sari jankari POP branch ke liye readily available hai. POP branch can find this information on our website, that is www.npscra.nsdl.co.in, jahan pe humne comprehensive FAQ rakha hai, jisme NPS ke related har ek topic par detailed information diya gaya hai. There is a dedicated corner for POPs where standard operating procedures for all activities performed by POPs and self-running demos are available. Also, you know, there are videos available on our YouTube channel about different features and benefits of NPS. POP branches should view these videos to get all the information about NPS. Iske alawa, NSDL CRA conducts regular training sessions for POP and POP branches in different cities of India where they are trained about NPS operations. We also visit POP and POP branches regularly in different locations and interact with them and provide them detailed information about NPS.
Sir, we understood that POP branch should have all information related to NPS so that they can create awareness among the subscribers about NPS, which will help subscribers to take informed decision while investing in NPS. Now, the next step is opening of NPS account. We have already talked about the process of NPS account opening through POP in one of our videos, which is available on this channel. So now tell us, sir, about the role of POP branch in NPS account opening.
Janvi, before POP branch starts subscriber registration process, they have to provide some important information to the subscriber, like investment option available, selection of pension fund manager who will invest their funds, percentage allocation in each asset class, that is equity, corporate bonds, government securities, scheme selection, etc. Along with this, POP branch has to inform subscriber that he can open Tier 1 and Tier 2 account together. But Janvi, before we discuss about POP branch role in NPS account opening, we need to know different modes of operations POPs have adopted. As mentioned earlier, the majority of POPs are banks and financial institutions who carry out their day-to-day operations through large network of branches. Now, these POPs have well-integrated back-office software, which is centrally available and is accessible by their branches. And they use the same back-office software for NPS operations as well. और अगर हम सब्सक्राइबर रजिस्ट्रेशन की बात करते हैं तो टू मेक सब्सक्राइबर रजिस्ट्रेशन प्रोसेस सीमलेस POPs have adopted online mode of subscriber registration. POP branch role will be depending on the mode of operations adopted by POPs. जैसे many POPs have made available an online interface to their subscribers for registration in NPS, जिसमें सब्सक्राइबर अपने अकाउंट में लॉग इन कर खुद अपने डिटेल्स ऑनलाइन सबमिट करता है. And because they are existing customer, most of the subscriber details are already available in POP back office system, and hence subscriber has to enter only minimum details. Because most of the time subscriber is an existing customer of POPs, POP branches need not do KYC separately. Once subscriber submit the details, PAN will be generated immediately. Okay. So in this cases, POP branch role is limited to collection of forms from the subscriber and sending the same to CRA. In second option, which is similar to the first option, only difference is that POP branch will accept the subscriber registration form and enter minimum details and fetch the remaining details from back office and process the form to generate PAN. Now, in this scenario, POP branch has to verify and authorize the form and send the same to CRA. And the third option, which is a traditional NPS account opening process, जिसमें subscriber physical account opening form भरकर supporting documents के साथ POP branch में submit करता है. POP branch form और supporting documents को verify करने के बाद CRA को submit करता है for further processing. CRA processes the form and generate PAN. In this process, subscriber has to provide all the details in the form, such as address details, contact details, bank details, nomination details, etc. In the first two options, PAN will get activated on T+1 day, where T is the date of submission of details by POP branch in back office. And in third option, which is a traditional process of PAN generation, where physical form is submitted, PAN generation may take longer time. But here I would like to highlight one point, that along with account opening form, POP branch has to collect initial contribution also from subscribers. Without submission of initial contribution, account opening form will not be processed.
Sir, you just mentioned that POP branch has to collect initial contribution along with application form. The question is, how this contribution amount will get credited into subscriber's account and what POP branch has to do for this?
Janvi, in case the subscriber has opened account online through POP portal login, the initial contribution will be done through bank transfer. After that, POP central office will upload contribution file in CRA system and units will be credited to subscriber's PAN. For subscribers who are not using the online facility, POP branch has to collect the initial contribution in the form of check or cash. बट पी ओ पी ब्रांच को यह ध्यान देना जरूरी है कि इनिशियल कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन अमाउंट शुड बी रियलाइज ओनली आफ्टर प्लान इज जनरेटेड. नाउ योर क्वेश्चन विल बी हाउ पी ओ पी ब्रांच कैन चेक द स्टेटस ऑफ द प्लान. तो पी ओ पी ब्रांच या तो बैक ऑफिस से या फिर सी आर ए सिस्टम में लॉग इन करके प्लान का स्टेटस जान सकता है. वन थिंग आई वुड लाइक टू मैंशन हियर दैट आफ्टर कलेक्टिंग द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ सब्सक्राइबर पी ओ पी हैज़ टू अपलोड कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन एम आई एस इन सी आर ए सिस्टम. Now, this has to be done in order to track the turnaround time by POP for uploading the contribution from the date of receipt of contribution. Also, subscriber will track the status of this request in CRA system with the help of receipt number. If POP branch do not upload MIS, subscriber will not be able to track the status of his request and he will have to come to POP branch, which may not be near to his place. Not only this, MIS upload is a part of regulatory obligations for POP and it is closely monitored and audited by regulator.
Sir, you just now talk about receipt number. How subscriber will come to know about the receipt number from POP branch?
Janvi, after POP branch receive subscriber account opening form and initial contribution, they have to generate receipt from back office system and give it to subscriber as an acknowledgement. This receipt number is a 70 digit running serial number. The first two digits indicates the type of subscriber request. For registration, first two digits would be 11 and for contribution, it is 12. POP branch should ensure that correct receipt number is generated on the basis of service request type. So after accepting registration form and initial contribution, POP branch has to give two separate receipts, one for registration and another for contribution. Subscriber can track status of his request with the help of this receipt number. Subscriber can also approach POP branch to know the status. ऐसी स्थिति में ब्रांच को अपने बैक ऑफिस सिस्टम से या CRS सिस्टम से रिक्वेस्ट स्टेटस लेकर सब्सक्राइबर को देनी होगी।
सर, नाउ वी नो हाउ POPs प्रोसेस द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन, बट हाउ सब्सक्राइबर विल कम टू नो दैट कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन गॉट क्रेडिटेड इनटू हिज प्लान?
जानवी, आफ्टर ईच कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन क्रेडिट, CRA सेंड्स SMS एंड ईमेल अलर्ट्स ऑन हिज रजिस्टर्ड मोबाइल नंबर एंड ईमेल ID. सब्सक्राइबर कैन ऑल्सो व्यू ऑनलाइन स्टेटमेंट बाय एक्सेसिंग CRS सिस्टम एंड व्यू द क्रेडिट एंट्री. If the units are not credited, subscriber may walk into POP branch office to check the status. In such cases, POP branch has to get the information from their back office and provide the same to the subscriber.
Thank you, sir, for the detailed information on subscriber onboarding. I am sure it will help POP branches to perform their day-to-day operations related to NPS and make subscriber onboarding process seamless. That's all in this video. In next video, we will talk about different services provided by POP branches. For more information on NPS, visit our YouTube channel NSDL NPS Ki Paathshala and don't forget to subscribe it. Thank you.